Let's be honest, painting miniatures is not exactly an inexpensive hobby to run, and that doesn't just mean the miniatures themselves, but all the different things around them, like all the hobby supplies and the tools that you use for them, can also cost a pretty penny. But that doesn't mean that we cannot use some really cheap household items lying around to make our lives easier and get the job done. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you 6 items that are all super cheap, super easily available. I use them every day, and I cannot even imagine painting miniatures without them.
Hey guys, I'm Zoltan, and you're watching Phalanx Miniatures.
So let's start with something that I think is not so well known, and that's the humble tinfoil. I have a roll of this lying around in my hobby space for 2 main reasons, plus a bonus one, I guess. The first reason is basing, because sometimes you do have your ground effect that you want to use, which is going to create the texture, but it cannot really create enough volume to, let's say, represent a hill or a big rock. In cases like this, there are a lot of different products that you can use. You can use cork, or you can use some kind of sculpting putty, you can use green stuff, Milliput, but all of these cost money, and sometimes you just don't have them handy. However, you always have a little bit of tinfoil around. So in cases like this, you can simply take a little bit of tinfoil, crumple it up, and then start shaping it into whichever shape you need. If you compact it enough, it's gonna be super hard, but at the same time, still easily shapeable, because you can always add a little bit more tinfoil to it and then just create another layer. And once you achieve the desired shape, you can just cover it up with some kind of basing material. If you don't like the texture of tinfoil itself, it can look like rock, I guess. But you can also make it look like, let's say, a hillside. This is especially useful when you are just creating volume and the thing that you are doing is not gonna be visible, I think. So you can do something really, really cool and artistic with, let's say, Milliput or green stuff, but if it's not even visible, it doesn't matter, right? So if it's gonna be covered by something, it might as well be tinfoil and super cheap. The second thing I use this for is for airbrushing. If you use an airbrush, and if you don't, then you probably should, because it's super fun, you probably came across this problem of you are airbrushing something, or you try, and that is in front of the model. So you don't want to hit the model itself, of course. And for this kind of situation, of course, there are a lot of different products like masking tapes and masking putties that you could use, but then you could also just use this. And as you can see, all you need to do is you take the tin foil, cover the model with it, and then start blasting. And once you are done, you simply remove the tin foil. It won't actually damage the model at all. It's super easy, and it gets the job done. And of course, for the third application, you need a tinfoil hat when you want to talk about all those cool theories that you have, but nobody wants to believe. For example, did you know that Games Workshop will release a new Eldar model, and it's gonna be, believe it or not, the second item is even cheaper than the first one, and that's simply a roll of paper towel. I use tinfoil quite a bit lately for both airbrushing and also for my bases, but this thing I use simply every day. The first application is something that I would not be able to live without, or at least paint without, because with this thing I actually can control how much paint gets on the mini. Before I start painting, I make sure that there is a couple of folded pieces of paper towel right under and next to my wet palette. And this helps me in many ways. First of all, I constantly clean my brush while I'm painting, and whenever I do that, I need something to dry it on. It is also there so that I can remove excess paint when I am getting the paint from the wet palette and before I apply it to the mini. And it's also the place where I try out how much paint and how much moisture that is in the brush before I start applying it to the mini itself. The second application is less glamorous, I suppose. It's not so much of a part of the painting process, it's more like a byproduct, because there is so many things that can spill while you are painting, and then this thing is there to wipe it off. And if you have been painting for a while, you probably know how much this actually happens, right? Because it can be glue, it can be paint, it can be water, non-oil. It can just go everywhere, and then having this around is a lifesaver. Not to mention how nice it is to have something like this around when you cut your finger, which will happen, believe me. The third item on the list is, well, it's so cheap that it comes for free most of the time, because, for example, this one I got in a box of minis. It's simply a piece of foam that was there to protect the minis in the box. I think this one came from an Infinity box specifically. And what you can do is you can just take off a little piece like that, and then use it to stipple your miniatures with and create chipping effects, for example. Those of you who follow the channel probably have seen me already use this on many of my different projects, and I think it's a super easy and extremely cheap way to apply weathering effects to your minis. Once you tore off a piece, all you need to do is to dip it into a little bit of dark paint, like for example Rhinox Hide is perfect for this, And then you remove the excess on some paper towel. See, item two is very, very useful. And then you apply it wherever you want the mini to be a little bit weathered and where you want the paint to be chipped. The fourth item is simply a paper clip. And the paper clip is really just the Swiss Army knife of miniature painting. You can remove the blockage from a bottle of paint with it, clean and scrape any kind of weird things out of small spaces, or you can, and this is my favorite, cut it into little pieces and use it as a pin for your miniatures. This is actually my favorite way of fixing minis to bases where they are not directly in contact with the base and I cannot just glue them because they are standing on some kind of product, like for example tin foil. I simply cut off small sections of the pin, then drill holes into the feet of the mini from below, insert the clip parts and use these then to fix the mini onto the base. But of course you can also use it to just pin the arm of the mini to the body. And if you're looking for something more heavy duty, because it's a bigger miniature, you can just exchange the clip for a nail. And of course, I don't mean that you should just, you know, hammer the nail into the mini or something. You can simply cut off a little part of the nail and then use that as a pin. The fifth item on the list is this little makeup applicator remover. I'm not sure what exactly it was meant to be, but it's extremely useful in removing oil paints. Once again, if you follow the channel, you might have come across some of the speed painting videos that I do, and occasionally I use oil washers because they are super effective at just painting fast. And whenever I do that, I use these little things to then remove the paint once I let it dry for a little bit, and then all the excess that I don't want on the mini, I just remove with these. And they're super nice because they are nice and fluffy and soft. Otherwise, you can use these cotton buds as well, but they are not even close to as good as these because they leave these like cotton strands behind and they can also be a little bit too hard, so you could remove the paint under the wash. So you might have these at home because maybe your wife or girlfriend has some, or you can just simply order them from Amazon in a big pack and they cost next to nothing. And the final item on the list is something that I've been using a lot since I started painting miniatures. It's something called multi-tech, but it can also be called blue tech, I guess, but this is white. And I think all of the stuff that I ever had was white or maybe gray like this one. Well, the color doesn't matter too much, but in the end, what it does, it allows you to attach something to something else temporarily. The primary application for this is that I attach my miniatures to the bases before I prime them, and I prime them with an airbrush. I'm just lazy and I don't usually do the bases before the priming process, so those are two separate processes for me, but I still want the mini to be standing and firmly standing on those bases when I am doing the priming. The other application is that you can also use this to attach certain parts of the mini and paint them in sub-assemblies if you want. So you can still see how the whole thing looks as attached, but then when you paint them, you can take it apart and paint it separately. Sub-assemblies are a whole different topic that I would love to talk about at some point because I really hate them and I don't think you should do them most of the time. But in very specific circumstances, this can actually be very, very useful. Finally, this can also be used to cover certain things just like tinfoil can. For example, you could be using it to mask certain parts of the mini and then you can just remove it without damaging it. Or you could even create certain patterns out of it because it's so easily moldable. There are probably a million other applications for this as well, and I just can't imagine ever painting without having this at hand. So these were the six very cheap but very useful household items that I use for my hobbying all the time. Did I miss something? Is there something out there that you guys use all the time and I don't know about? Please let me know in the comments. I hope that you guys found this video useful and maybe even found something new that you can incorporate into your own painting process. If you did, please consider giving the video a like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out, and see you in the next one.